I love that sound.
The Xbox Series X is Microsoft's top-of-the-line next-gen console, and this is our first good look at it, at home and actually plugged in. As with each new console generation, Microsoft promises this one is faster, more powerful, and prettier than the Xboxes that came before. And so far, that's entirely accurate. Because, duh. But this new system has a few features that deserve extra attention before launch day on November 10th. Before we dive in too deep, let's set some expectations. There are a few rules around today's first look, limiting what I'm allowed to talk about. So today we'll only be discussing the performance of the backward compatible library, the quick resume feature, and the look and feel of the hardware itself, including the new Xbox wireless controller. First up, the backward compatible library on Xbox Series X. On day one, both of Microsoft's next-gen consoles, the Series X and all-digital Series S, will support more than 500 games from the original Xbox, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. That's a library 19 years deep. Alongside selling Game Pass Ultimate subscriptions, this is a huge part of Microsoft's pitch for the next generation. The fact that Series X will have plenty of content at launch, and these titles will perform better than ever. Meanwhile, Microsoft's main competitor, Sony, hasn't clearly outlined how backward compatibility will work on the PlayStation 5. We know that some PS4 games will be playable on PS5, but it's still unclear which ones, how they'll take advantage of the new hardware, or if they'll be accessible outside of a PlayStation Plus subscription. There's no word on games from before the PS4 era either. On Series X, all backward compatible games receive automatic HDR support, and some will even play at double their original frame rates, bumping 30 FPS titles to 60 and 60 to 120. This library will run natively on the Series X, meaning each game can take advantage of the console's faster CPU, GPU, and SSD. Aside from boosting the visual fidelity of classic titles across the board, this all results in one major feature: faster load times. In my experience, games on Xbox Series X load 3 to 4 times faster than their Xbox One counterparts. Take Remedy's Control, for example. Booting up a scene on Xbox One takes 30 to 38 seconds, while the same scene on Series X consistently takes just 9 seconds, 10 at the most. This ratio rings true for most games I've tested, and it's significantly changed the way I interact with the new console overall. Traditionally, whenever I die or fast travel in most AAA games, I automatically drop the controller while waiting for the scene to load, knowing it'll take enough time to give my fingers a break. Or I'll grab a fresh drink or reach for my phone and scroll through Reddit or whatever. With Series X, there's no time for this nonsense. When a fail state pops up, my hands will instinctually fall to my lap, but almost immediately, the game is ready for another round. I've had to become more proactive with my drink breaks. Not only are Series X backward-compatible games faster to load, but many of them take advantage of another speedy new console function, Quick Resume. This might be the coolest software feature of the Xbox Series X. Quick Resume allows players to toggle between several active games at once, rather than having to close out one title before loading another. In my experience, games load between 5 and 10 seconds, and my character is always exactly where I left them. There's no hard cap on the number of games that can be suspended in Quick Resume, but there is a hardware-based limit. The console's SSD contains a cache that stores system RAM for each game that's suspended, and this can fill up, preventing additional titles from using the feature. So, the number of games will mainly depend on the memory usage of the titles you're pausing. Microsoft hasn't said how large the Quick Resume SSD cache is, but I've been able to cycle through 5 games at a time just fine. Not every title supports Quick Resume, though a majority of the ones I've tested do. Firewatch, for instance, does not have the feature, but Control, Don't Starve, Felix the Reaper, Resident Evil 7, Blair Witch, Untitled Goose Game, and Sunset Overdrive do. And finally, for two features that every Series X game definitely supports, the Xbox wireless controller and the console itself. Microsoft has a solid track record in gamepad design, and the new wireless controller is no exception, mainly because it doesn't deviate much from its predecessors. It's essentially an Xbox One controller, with a nod to the Elite in the D-pad, an extra share button, and a flat face. For seasoned Xbox players, this one will feel like home. And sound like it. Meanwhile, the Series X looks nothing like Microsoft's previous consoles. It's a rectangular black prism that's just under a foot tall and about half as wide and deep. It has a tripophobic top and a friendly, glowing Xbox logo in the upper left corner. Most importantly though, it actually looks great in a living room. It can be laid on its side for horizontal shelving, and so far, it's quiet as hell. Take this short story for example. One day last week, after playtesting the Series X for quite a few hours, I booted up my PS4 to play Overwatch, which is what happens, like, every night at my house. As the game began to load, the PS4 fan kicked on and it was shocking. I hadn't realized just how silent the Series X was until the current gen reminded me. Turns out, the future sounds pretty nice. That's everything we can share for now. I've only had a few days with the Series X so far, but I'll keep on playing and testing, and we'll be back in the coming weeks with more preview details and impressions. And eventually, we'll share full reviews of all the new consoles coming out this holiday season. For all the latest gaming news, subscribe to the Engadget YouTube channel, and stay tuned to Engadget.com.